Good morning. Wonderful day, an exciting day today with our graduation and honoring our graduates, and it's good to see everyone here. Some announcements. We have geraniums up here. If you can spend a few minutes after worship and plant them, that would be great, because some of us can't do that at all. So if you can stay. In the insert in the bulletin, I don't know if you understand really what's happening with the Ashland County Cancer Association. They're having an annual rummage sale, and the details are on the back of the bulletin. And this is a service project for us. And there will be pies, and if you're able to come, here are the days and the times. And there's a sign-up sheet if you would like to work on bulletin board back here. You can't miss it. It's bright color. Let us prepare our hearts for worship. Thank you very much. I invite you to stand if you're able for the call to worship. We have come to worship Almighty God. We praise and honor our Savior, Jesus Christ. Let the celebration begin. Let's sing Victory in Jesus. Mm-hmm. Let us join together in our prayer of praise. Jesus, our victorious Savior, we rejoice with Evan, Josie, and Olivia. We celebrate this milestone in their lives. We believe they will succeed in life because of your presence, power, and love. Lord, bless each one with your Holy Spirit. Alleluia. Amen. Please be seated. Our biggest joy today, besides graduation, are those who went over to Dale Abel's house yesterday and did a lot of cleaning up, and we thank each and every one of you. I think it's going to require another trip, but thank you. Thank you. Our prayer concerns Ray Hall is home, which is good news, and continue to pray for him and all on our prayer list. Let us go to God. Gracious God, what a crazy school year it has been. Though life has not been easy, we have persevered because of your love and grace. We give thanks for the communities serving the Hillsdale, Ashland, South Central, Loudonville, and other school districts. Within each community, the sport has been fantastic. Thank you, Jesus, for guiding us. We are especially grateful for the teachers, aides, staff, and administration of each building and each district. Thank you for working through these dedicated individuals. Lord, you have been with each student and family throughout the year. When we consider all that has happened, we realize that your Holy Spirit never took a day off. When we experienced trials, the Spirit never diminished. And Lord, we stand in awe of you. We pause to pray for each person on our prayer list, others we name in our hearts, and our nation. We pray for healing and wholeness. Oh Lord Jesus, we cast all our cares upon you. Help us lay our burdens at your feet, leaving them there, and fill us with your strength. We pray in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, who taught us all to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. You see, favorite scriptures, each of these folks shared their favorite scripture. I think they're fantastic. So I would like us to read each one together, starting with Psalm 46, verse 10. Be still and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the nations. I will be exalted in the earth. Psalm 16, 8. I have set the Lord always before me. Because he is at my right hand, I will not be shaken. And finally, Isaiah 41, verse 10. So do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you and help you. I will uphold you with my righteous hand. Oh, fantastic. Now the final two hymns were picked by, two of them picked Amazing Grace and the other It Is Well With My Soul. So you remain seated for the first three verses of Amazing Grace.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound. As Good morning. Today is such a special day as we recognize and celebrate three graduating seniors, Evan, Josie, and Olivia. Although I've only been the youth leader for a few years now, I definitely have been blessed to have grown with these kids. Actually, in some of the pictures in the PowerPoint, there's one picture. It's a big group picture at Round Lake, and I actually think I am in youth group at that time, and they are little, so. Evan, Josie, and Liv, you three are such wonderful and genuine people. We are all so excited for you as you prepare for your next adventures. I am personally thankful to have been able to lead such a great group of kids. We've made some pretty great memories and shared some pretty good laughs. As I prepared this PowerPoint presentation, I could not help but just smile looking at all the pictures. At this time, we'll have the three seniors will come up and you'll be able to hear a little bit about them. And then we will continue on with the presentation.
Okay, so I'm Evan Jones. I'm going to Kent State for business. I played football in school. My favorite church memory is the ruck wall at the retreat center. And that's about it.
Okay. My name's Olivia. After high school, I'm going to the University of Findlay to major in diagnostic medical sonography. Some school and church activities, FFA, softball, volleyball, student council are some of them. Church activities, just the youth group, like going to a live and retreat and things like that. One of my favorite memories was at a live when... When Ashley, we had carrots, okay? And no one would eat the carrots. And every meal, Ashley was like, "Do you guys want carrots? Do you guys want carrots?" And
she's 100 degrees outside.
And she just kept asking us for carrots. So that's definitely one of my favorite memories. So yeah.
I'm Josie, and I'm going to the University of Toledo for exercise science and then physical therapy after. And some school activities. I do cheer, softball, basketball, National Honor Society, FFA. One of my favorite church memories is probably at Round Lake. So we all thought it would be a good idea to go down the water slide that was closed. And to make it slippery, we used Round Lake soap. And they found out and were not happy, so we got in trouble.
Thank you, seniors. As you can see, there's a few personal memories and everything else, but all of them resulted in smiles. So before you sit down, we'd like to present you each with a gift. Am I allowed to hug you?
Evan,
so again, congratulations to each of you. As you close this chapter and prepare for your next, I hope you feel God's presence in your heart and that He is guiding you every step of the way. Jeremiah 29 reads, "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you a hope and a future. No matter the obstacles you face or the path that you take, trust in Him. Always remember your roots and know that your JUMC church family will always be here for you." So with that being said, on behalf of the Drumsville United Methodist Church, we presented each of you with these Bibles. Evan, Josie, and Olivia, congratulations on your graduation. Best wishes to you as you begin this next chapter of your life. God has a plan for each of you, and we cannot wait to see where you go. Thank you. So if you could please turn your attention to the screen, we will show you the senior PowerPoint.
Great.
Needles, essential for sewing, but maybe not for people.
How cool. Thank you, Ashley, for putting it all together and picking parents for providing pictures, and it's great. Well, that's good. I invite you to stand for verses 4, 5, and 6 of Amazing Grace. Gospel from Matthew 7. Anyone who listens to my teaching and obeys me is wise, like a person who builds a house on solid rock. Though the rain comes in torrents and the flood waters rise and the winds beat against the house, it won't collapse because it is built on rock. But anyone who hears my teaching and ignores it is foolish, like a person who builds a house on sand. When the rains and floods come and the winds beat against that house, it will fall with a mighty crash. May God add his blessing to the reading and the hearing of his holy word. Please be seated. Graduation is a bittersweet time. Even had me in tears earlier. But joy and excitement for Evan, Olivia, and Josie, and all graduates, proud parents, grandparents, siblings, and other family members, and the anticipation leading up to the ceremony this afternoon at 2 has been a combination of happiness and sadness. I mean, some things you won't miss at all from high school. But on the flip side, the last ball game, the last track meet, the concert, FFA event, and so much more. Indeed, it is bittersweet. And all three of you are headed off to college, and I'm really excited because I do believe you will be living on campus. It's the best experience ever to be on campus. And you will be okay, for your family has prepared you well. Your church has been here for you and will continue to be here, so look for care packages during finals week. You have received a solid foundation in school, preparing you for what lies ahead. We pray you have received a solid foundation of faith in this place. And I was extremely impressed with the scriptures that you chose. They show deep insight into how your faith is being formed through the power and presence of God in your lives. You know what you believe, as it has been expressed through your life, through school, community, and the church family. Stay true to your faith. Difficulties will come, temptations will be strong. Torrents of rain will flood the basement of your spiritual house. High winds will rip off some shingles, trying to turn you away from God. Do not fear. Your house will endure because your faith is built on the solid foundation of Jesus Christ. Your house, being a dorm or apartment, will be a place of safety, and I hope it's a lot of fun, too. Your spiritual house is also a place of safety, where your faith will grow ever stronger. Your faith can endure anything life throws at it. Be assured of God's presence and love, and be assured that this community of faith will lift you in prayer and cheer you on and rejoice in all your successes. Enjoy your graduation this afternoon. Celebrate and rejoice. May it be well with your souls. Amen. I invite you to stand in the small red hymnal, 99. It is well with my soul.
Thank you.
everyone is invited to stop over here and have cake. Evan, Josie, and Olivia, go in God's peace and our love. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, we pray. Amen.